prince of Poonanny has climbed. I've climbed my way up to the top of the pecking order of the food chain. I am now officially a YouTube channel partner. And the people are going to go, already the haters are pouring in. They're like, Cruiser, they...
Oh! If you don't recognize that voice, you don't recognize who that is, I pretty much envy you at this point. Now, I feel, as someone who talks about the kind of things that I do on YouTube, someone who posts the kind of videos that I do, I feel it is my duty to inform the intelligentsia, the more well-versed, the YouTube users that have a bit more perspicacity than the next guy. How about that? The smarter ones. It's my duty to inform you of what you're missing while you're completely ignoring the shit that seems to pour onto YouTube on a daily basis. Why? I don't know. I just think, you know, it's better to see things from another light instead of sticking to, you know, just one, you know, one side. You can't eat fried chicken and greens forever, you know. Sometimes, eventually, you have to add some beans to the mix, you know. Or if you want to eat fried chicken and greens for the rest of your life, fine. You know, some people just like that. But for me, personally, I like mixing things up a little bit. You know, I like a little danger and fun in my life. So I'd like to pass along to you another idiot on the YouTube stage. And I'm not just saying this because of his videos. I'm saying this because I've had conversations with this guy. His name is McHenry Cruiser. The self-professed Prince of Poonanny. The self-professed most handsome guy on YouTube. This guy is balder than the kneecaps of a gay prostitute, okay? And he goes around calling himself the most handsome man on YouTube and berating others for not being as handsome as him or not going to the gym as often as he does. This guy, he is another one of those guys who takes the thumbnails on his videos and puts in something completely unrelated, such as boobs, breasts, testicles, something very, very flashy to get the average idiot's attention, and that's how he has 11,000 subscribers. And I can't figure out how the hell the guy's popular. And then I figured it out. This guy partakes in another puke-inducing form of YouTube culture. He does sub for subs. He doesn't get his subscribers through pure comedy, because if he did, he'd have as many subscribers as me. But the guy does sub for sub, and if you don't know what sub for sub is basically where you have someone subscribe to you if you subscribe to them. It's kind of like whoring on MySpace back in the day, where the mark of the average moron's pride was to have as many friends as the next guy. Thousands and thousands of friends that they never talked to, okay? W for W, whore for whore. So that's what this guy is all about. So I went onto his channel, one of his videos, and I gave my humble little retort to one of his videos, and all he had to say to me is that I like wrestling and I like seeing other guys in tights wrestle, and that completely usurps all of my credibility. Well, what exactly gives one credibility? Calling themselves the Prince of Poonanny? Saying that they are more handsome than everyone, including me, which I don't care about. I know I'm as ugly as the next bastard out there. What credibility do you possibly have, Mr. McHenry Cruiser, when you're putting fake pictures in your thumbnails, when the majority of your fan base is sub for subbed? I mean, come on, what kind of credibility is that? You have as much credibility as Ray William Johnson, which isn't much. And I was actually thinking of putting a clip of one of his videos in here, but then I thought that I wouldn't be any better than Ray William Johnson if I stole someone else's clip and put it in my video. You know, taking someone else's work. You know, I've already been through all of that. But yes, the guy's name is McHenry Cruiser, and he is a total D-bag. Saying that I have no credibility because based on something I enjoy watching. Well, yes, I don't know how much credibility I have. I'm just another dickhead on YouTube with a camera and an opinion. But when you sit there and you make a video proclaiming that you've climbed to the top of the YouTube mountain because you've become a partner, that is not credible, my friend. That is pretty much whoring yourself out to the masses, especially YouTube. Okay? Just go through one of his videos, or go through his videos, and at the top there's a video that says, I am now officially a YouTube partner. And it's basically a 7-minute harangue on how he is now at the top the pinnacle of the YouTube mountain because he's become a YouTube fucking partner. And he said the haters, he's like, the haters are pouring in because, well, I have a video. They said that one of my videos can be used as a partnership. No, all of my videos are partnerships. Well, congratulations. You sold your soul to the YouTube machine to get a little advertising revenue. And you did it the cheapest way possible by getting people to subscribe for you, sub for sub. People who have no idea what you're about. You see, it's not good enough to have a fan base. It's just not good enough to have a fan base or a number on your fan base. It's good to have people who know what you're about. As much as I hate Ray William Johnson, at least the fans that he suckered in know what he's about. The majority of your fans, Mr. Baldo Cruiser, do not know a damn thing about you because you just told them to subscribe to you because you subscribe to them. And conversely, you don't know what any of your fans are about. You know? So basically, you're making money the cheap way, and I applaud you. If I wanted to do that, I could do it too. I could ask you all to subscribe to me, and I'll subscribe to you. And I could just do it on a mass scale. You can go to my Facebook, MySpace, Twitter, everything. Sub to me. And I could probably have 10,000 by the end of the year, and I could probably be a partner just like you. But no, I can't. Because I have something called dignity, and I have something, called shame every now and then, you know. Every now and then. You know, I don't always have shame. This guy just struck me as odd. I mean, the minute I saw him, it's kind of hard to believe he's a Prince of Poonanny when he sounds like this. You know, he sounds like a bona fide gay guy. You know, I don't know what it is about him. Hell, I don't know what it is about most of the people on YouTube, but they get popular and they get subscribers. And then people like them come to me and tell me that I'm jealous because I'm making fun of them. Well, where's the fun in having everybody agree with what somebody says? Where's the fun in that? Things would get very boring after a while. Where's the fun in everybody just loving everything and not having a single voice against it? I am one of those voices against it. Even at the expense of being called jealous that I don't have all the subscribers, I'm the voice against that. It doesn't make me any better. It doesn't make me a voice of reason, per se. To some people it might be, but no. Well, what the fuck would be the fun in everybody going to Ray William Johnson's videos and saying, this guy rules, and making videos about how he rules? It's time to, you gotta rock the boat every now and then and say how much he sucks. And a guy like Gus Monkey TV, it's probably there in an annotation I'll be too lazy to write. He does that, and he does it a very good job with it. He does all of his video editing, and it's very awesome. He's a monkey puppet. You should go watch his shit. But McHenry Cruiser is nothing but just another low-life scum on the pond of YouTube. I mean, to call someone, to say someone has no credibility after using fake thumbnails to sucker people in and making a video calling himself the self-professed king of YouTube because he became a partner and the Prince of Poonanny, all these things, they don't make you credible. They just make you fucking annoying. And that's what I gotta say about that. And keep watching for more awesome shit. No? Well, fuck you.